We all know that tide is a very important part when you go out for survey. There are many different ways that we can measure the tide, but today we are going to discuss about the traditional way how you can measure a tide. So to measure a tide, first of all, you need a tide gauge, right? It's obvious. But more than the tide gauge, you need a datum point, because the tides are always, most of the cases are above the datum and depths are below the datum. We have discussed this before. So how do we know where is our datum? And to know about our datum, we need to have a benchmark first. Okay, let's draw it on a chalkboard. Suppose this is our benchmark, and benchmark says my datum is, say, 5 meters below this benchmark point is my datum. Whatever datum it may be your sounding datum, your LAT, lowest astronomical tide, or it may be chart datum. So this is the primary thing that we need. And then we need something called a jetty from where to install our tide gauge. So suppose this is a jetty point, and from this particular jetty point, if we lower our tide gauge, and this is the sensor of the tide gauge, we need to measure how much we have lowered. Suppose we have lowered the ATG 8 meters from this point on the jetty. Okay, so that is the second part. The next part that we need to do is to measure the height difference between our benchmark and the jetty point. And suppose the benchmark is higher by 0.5 meter. Okay, so now we know that benchmark is higher than the jetty point, 0.5 meter, and my tide gauge is 8 meter. The zero of the tide gauge is 8 meter below the jetty. Okay, and I also know the 5 meter is from my benchmark to my datum. Now with all this data, I can calculate where is my datum from this jetty point. So where it is going to be? So I can see this 5 meter, it is 0.5 meter above. So my datum is going to be somewhere here, 4.5 meter below this jetty point, right? This 5 meter, it is above half a meter. Simple mathematics, 4.5 meter from this jetty point. So if I know that, then I need to find out where is my sensor with respect to my datum. This is datum. And this is also datum. Okay, so 8 meter minus 4.5 meter, and that will be become 3.5 meter. So I know that from the datum, the zero of my tide gauge is 3.5 meter down. Okay, now if I am calculating the tide, if I am getting the tide somewhere in the tide gauge, and the tide is, say, it's telling me 10.5 meter tide at so and so time, then I have to take out this point, because as I told you, the tide is always above datum. Okay, and I am measuring tide from here to the water line, and I cannot count this as a tide. So I have to take out 3.5 meter from 10.5 meter minus 3.5 meter is equal to 7 meter is going to be my tide. Okay, so that is how we measure tide traditionally. As a surveyor, you have to know where is your benchmark, where you can go and install your tide gauge. Make sure that the area where you are installing tide gauge does not dry out in the low water. Then you install the tide gauge as low as it can be. Carry out a leveling between the benchmark and the tide gauge point. Find out the height difference, and then calculate that from the top of the jetty, or from where you have lowered the tide gauge, where is your datum. Then subtract that to get the tide gauge under the datum. Okay, from what, how much you have lowered, and then you get your tide from the datum. So I hope this small video is helpful to you. Always ask questions and be curious. I'll see you in the next video.